morning, guys and girls. We're off to Bowsaw this morning. It's a beautiful little lake out in the country near Odium, down the M3, near Basingstoke, which is where I'm from. So it's a nice little lake. It's got a bit of everything, but it isn't a difficult water. It's a pleasure water, really. There are some bigger fish in here, but you very rarely catch them. There's a lot of smaller fish, which, you know, range anything from a couple of pound up to, you know, mid-teens, and that's what you generally catch. There are some other species in here that you can always end up catching. There's some nice chub and barbel which have been stocked in here, and lots of different carp of various shapes and sizes, some nice mirrors and some commons, but there's also some koi, and I've even caught a sort of fantail looking goldfishy kind of fish down here before, which maybe came out of someone's fish tank, or I don't know, but it was quite pleasant to catch. But yeah, it's not a serious water, good water to come if you're trying to get back into fishing, or trying to get someone back into fishing. I'm meeting my mate Jonesy here today, and yeah, he's fished as a young lad, but not for many years, so perfect lake to get him back into it. You don't have to be right up on all your tackle and all your gear to catch fish down here. You will always catch fish. Bait doesn't really matter, anything. I use the little guru method feeders with some little pellets, and to be honest, I use up all my old bait from the big trips. I've just come back from France for a week out there, so I've got plenty of leftover bits and pieces, old boilies, old particle, anything you've got really will work down here. It doesn't really matter. It's a great match lake. In fact, they have matches every Sunday here, and some of the match weights hit 200 pound plus in 5 hours. So yeah, lots of stock, lots of fun. Lake's got a bit of everything to offer, some nice little features, pretty little place. So yeah, we're just about to arrive, wait for my mate to get here, have a little walk around and pick a swim, and we'll get going. We're in 18 and 19 on Bowsaw. There's actually a match on here today, which we didn't know about, which is on 1 to 15. It's my dodgy mate in the bush over there. Yeah, so this island in front kind of splits the lake in two, and the match is on the other side, so we've got this side of the lake to ourselves today. But it's crammed full of stuff in here. Nice little willows hanging, rushes in the middle to fish up to. It's stacked full of features. It's just a miniature lake. But yeah, there's loads of good fish in here. We'll definitely have some out today. I'll try and capture most of them just to show you what they look like. They're not big ones, as I said before, but yeah, wicked lake.
That one. Don't blame the tackle. on, Jamesy, what are you playing at? Hey, got the same rod as got now, no complaints. Well done, that boy.
If it comes off now.
Yeah, I was going to do that.
Huh?
I was going to do it. That's a lovely fish.
Yeah.
It's about £30.
£30, yeah.
£30. Thank you. Jonesy 2, Ali 1. You've got two, have you? Two all.
That's on a nut. That's on a macadamia. Yeah. My little secret pot. When the times get tough, get your nuts out.
I did check the rules because a lot of places you're not allowed to use them. Can't mention anything about it. Thank you.
The Jones Meister is in.
It's
a nice little bend there.
Hand on the knee, he's relaxed.
It's a pro. He's been fishing for a day, isn't he?
Well, while we haven't been recording, Steve Jones has had 67 perch. To the total of 4 ounces.
Yeah, but he's also lost 460. That's lovely, isn't it?
Little barbel rods, can't beat a bit of 1 pound action on the rod. Look at that, love it. You know how the clutch works, yeah?
Sorry, a what?
A who? I thought that was on a car.
It's going to be quite a nice size, you know?
Yeah.
Bigger than a shit perch,
anyway. Or the 64 perch.
Yeah, sorry, yeah.
It's been like this before here, at sort of midday, it goes quiet.
Yeah.
It's a nice pretty little mirror. They do scrap well, don't they?
Yeah, they do. Yeah, there's nothing like.
We'll have a word about your missus then.
I switched to bread to get that as well.
Did you? What, a little flake or a little,
flake.
Pressed? Just a little flake.
Pressed on the top of the hook.
All time classic bait. It will never stop working, bread, will it? Come on, I know you've got a new rod and reel, but you've got to get it in at some point. Ding! That's it. You're in. Oh. Just crush me, bait. Give you a tub of bait, and you just. You shouldn't have had that curry last night.
Hey, it's a nice size. So what you need to do, you need to take a photograph of my phone.
I can send you it on mine. It's just right on the bottom of his lip there, right on the edge. Look at that.
It's just covering that.
You got a little tench.
Yeah.
Got your net stuck on the post. That's all right. Little tench. Bonus fish.
That beautiful, aren't they?
Yeah. Quality they are. Oh, it's got a
dink in it, hasn't
it? Yeah, it has. Yeah, a bit of line around it or something. Sometime.
Yeah.
Here we are then, last fish of the day. Put the GoPro away, so I'm recording this on my mobile. So sorry about the shakiness. But yeah, had a great day. Jonesy's had a good day, he's already gone home. And I'm just about to get this last one in the net and pack up myself. Yeah, as I said before, great little lake for newcomers, people trying to get into angling for the first time, or maybe like Jonesy, a few years without any fishing, so it's just a nice place to come and have a go. This one's giving me a little bit of scrap, but holding a phone doesn't help. Here we go. No, not quite. So yeah, if you're local to Basingstoke area, go in the net. And you want to have a good day out, a bit of fun fishing, have a go at Bowsaw. Cracking little lake, loads of features, and some nice little fish as well. Take it easy.